It's about the two preachers that I miss the most because they are useless on Skype. I'm originally from Estonia, you see, and I moved 2 years ago to the UK. And actually, there's a third preacher who is useless on Skype, and that's my father. If he's watching now, it's really embarrassing. But there are these creatures in my life that are distant now. And I remember them with great fondness. I want to focus on two of them, the furry ones. So in the picture, the one that you see is Susanna, or we call her Susie. Susanna, we usually say when she's messed up. And when you look at her, you see that she's a typical cat. She really knows how to relax and sleep. That's her favorite activity, sleep. Now there are occasions when she wakes, and sometimes this comes with certain weird symptoms. You know, when cats go mad in your house and they kind of want to be everywhere at the same time, and they have this crazy look in their eyes, and they run around, and you see that look? You see that look? That crazy look when their pupils go crazy and they're out to get you. So this is what she sometimes looks like, and this is what she looks when the phase is at the peak. But what she does the best is sleep. That's her true talent. Completely at peace, rest. And I know that some of us imagine that this picture is a perfect illustration of a Sabbath day. Now, we also have another pet, and he's called Frederick, or Freddy, and he's a dog. And he also knows how to sleep, usually on top of his people. Sometimes in the bed, so if you saw this, Freddy in my bed, the next slide is Freddy in my sister's bed, the next slide is Freddy on me, the next slide is Freddy on one of our guests. And you can see that he's very good with relationships. But the thing that he's the best at is a weird activity. It's waiting. This is Freddy waiting at the door. The next picture is Freddy waiting at the door. The next is Freddy waiting at the window. And this is the kind of watercolor paintings that he paints with his nose as he's waiting on the window. Now, I wish I knew how to wait like Freddy. Because when he waits and he knows that there is somebody missing from home, he waits with every fiber of his being. He waits so that the hair of his tail are tense. He sits on that windowsill and he goes. And sometimes he breathes in and then goes. He waits with such intensity that I sometimes think it must hurt. Do you know a waiting dog? Have you ever seen one yourself? Have you ever had one wait for you this way, with intensity? Because he knows that when his people are not there, something is missing. I wish I had the talent to wait like this. For you see, in the Bible, it reads, in Psalm 130, I wait for the Lord. My whole being waits. I wait for the Lord more than watchmen wait for the morning. And here the psalmist thinks that it's not enough to say it just once. You know, it's the chorus, it's the thing that matters. No, you don't understand. I wait for the morning more than watchmen wait for the morning. That's how I wait. That's how I wait. With every fiber second time to bring salvation to those who are waiting for him. You see, we have a choice today. What's our Sabbath going to be like? More like the take a nap and digest good lunch type of a Sabbath? Or more of a ready kind of Sabbath? Waiting for the Lord, because he has promised to return, and because we know in our hearts that we will not be whole and cannot be content till he